All right, welcome to the Filthy Kitchen. I'm the Squadron. I woke up today, splitting headache. My tooth is killing me once again, which is very sad for me because I'm supposed to be seeing the dentist now in a week or two. And I'm hoping that this doesn't flare up again. That would be dreadful. I need this root canal. I've been waiting for it, and now I'm worried. So anyway, that's what's going on with me. In other news, I did ride the bike. I did 600 calories on the bike. I have been doing 700 on the weekend, but it's exhausting. So I'm thinking that I must be fighting some sort of infection. This tooth is flared up again, and just riding the bike or whatever is so difficult these days. So, I don't know. My body seems to be worn down, which is terrible, because I'm trying to get back in shape. And it seems like there's always something. So that's my news. So I woke up, my tooth was killing me, my head was splitting. I took some Advil and some Tylenol, which I hate to do, but I gotta work. I felt like calling in sick, of course, but I can't do that. The pain was so bad, I felt dizzy. Which makes sense, because this nerve goes right up past my ear. My temple hurts, my ear. So my equilibrium was thrown off. I was a bit dizzy when I got up. I thought I might have an ear infection. I thought I might have to call in sick. I mean, I can't drive if I'm dizzy, but I don't feel dizzy anymore. And when the pain pills kick in, hopefully they'll do the trick. But again, quite disheartening. Yeah, so I'm running slightly late. I got coffee made, and now I'm making these steaks. Butter. I need some butter. All right, steak should be ready. Put that there. Gonna need some butter on that. I've got two other steaks. This one needs to be seasoned. I'm going to cook the two of these at the same time. A little bit of salt. Some pepper. Flip it over. And repeat. A little salt. and some pepper. Alrighty, throw these in. So other than that, that's pretty much what's going on with me. My mother is in the hospital. She was feeling sick out at my aunt's house, where she's been staying for the past month. And she felt sick and weak, so my aunt worried and called an ambulance and had my mother taken to the hospital. The doctor called and had my information, so I gave my father's phone number, and the doctor said she's fine. He was wondering why she was in there. I guess they changed shifts at the hospital, and anyway, he got in touch with my father, and basically said things are all right with her, but they're going to keep her there for a few days. So anybody who's been following this sort of family drama, that's what's been going on there. So I was not able to go in to see her. My cousin was there and called me. But I had to pick my daughter up after school, so the hospital called me at 6 o'clock in the morning. I was at work, luckily, so they didn't wake me up or anything. But then when I came home from work, I spoke to my father briefly. Then I had to go to sleep because I had to get my daughter, and then I got up, I picked her up, and came back and went back to sleep. So she's fine, that's the main thing. So they're going to keep her and watch her for a few days, and then we'll see what happens then. Alright, these steaks are just about done. I don't have much of an appetite, but coffee's made, the steak is made. It's getting late. Hopefully this will get me through my shift tonight. Good that I got back on the bike. I'm happy about that, but man, it was tough. And I'm not too happy that I haven't been boxing or lifting weights or stretching. I've just been hard trying to get back in shape, let me tell you. Recovery is not going well. Well, what are we doing on time? We'll end it here. So remember who loves your baby, this guy. Also remember you're somebody's favorite person in this world. Probably mine. For those of us going through tough times, let's hang in there and try to be positive. Remember, I love you. Talk soon. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.